gratitude and blessings for the future. As we celebrate this amazing centennial celebration, let us worship our God who has been blessing us 100 years with his guidance and our amazing abundant blessings. So this morning, let's pray, let's praise our God with our heart, with whole heart. Let God show our gratitude, appreciation this morning. Would you please stand for call to worship? We gather today to celebrate 100 years of mission and ministry in this faith community. We give you thanks for the saints before us who have prayed, worshiped, and studied and given of themselves as missionaries. May we continue to be a reflection of the faith of those who have prepared the way for us. We open our lives to this moment, realizing that our spirit has led us to this place, and that is your spirit calling us into the future. And those who come after us. In the name of Christ Jesus, our Lord, we pray. Amen. Let's praise God with hymn 77. Please be seated. I know we are celebrating this special Sunday, but still it's a Sunday worship service. So this is a church moment. We're going to have it. This is church, right? Church moment. We are supporting each other. We pray for each other and share joys and concerns together. That's the church. So we're going to have a church moment. But let's announcement first.
Good morning, friends.
Morning.
Thank you so much for being here today. My heart is super, super full. For those of you that are visiting, welcome. I just can't tell you how much stress has gotten us to this day and hard work. And so just, I know I'll say it a lot of times today, but I want to thank everyone who pedal pushed and chair pushed and chair and table pushed to get us to this day. Just a couple, a very quick announcement about lunch. We did have some cancellations. So if you did not have a lunch reservation, look for me. I think we might be able to accommodate a few, okay? That being said, just a little logistic note about lunch. There are some choices today that you'll need to make, hopefully before you leave this room and go next door. We have box lunches from Apple Spice Junction. Those of you that are familiar know that they do a really lovely job. But we will have turkey avocado sandwiches or a cafe club, which is ham, turkey, and bacon. So please be thinking in your mind what you'd like to have for lunch today. And then if you don't have a ticket, you're not gonna get a lunch. Just telling you. I'm gonna go full librarian, no ticket, no lunch. So, but if you don't have a reservation, please come see me. You'll pick up your, you'll make your way next door through the breezeway, pick up your lunch, pick up a water bottle, and then go into the social hall, which has been so lovingly prepared for you to enjoy today. So, that being said, just make sure that you've made that choice before you get over there, because we'd like to, you know, keep things moving and not have a traffic jam in the breezeway here. All right? Are we good? All right. Thank you again for being here, and thank you so, so much.
Yeah. Leah has been putting a lot of time and effort to it. We all know. So let's give our big appreciation to Leah. Thank you. So you know what to do? See? So after the service, go to the patio area, pick up food, and then go to the fellowship hall, and then there's a nice setup of dining tables. So you can sit there, have lunch together, and then after lunch, what are you gonna do? Come back here. Don't go home. I'm telling you, don't go home. We have a great program, Centennial Celebration Program follow-up. So after lunch, and then come back here, we're going to have a great centennial celebration with a distinguished guest and the good-looking Asian pastor, and then, right? And we have like a group of singers, so that'll be great, okay? So you come lunch, come back here, and then and we celebrate together, continual celebration. Okay. Flower offering for our great abundant God's blessing. So that's beautiful flowers dedicated to our anniversary, for the anniversary. And Stillman Sawyer Family Service Center food basket donated by Overton family. Memorizing Dick Overton. You know, the Overton family has been amazing in our church history, serving, you know. So that's, I think it's really appropriate, and then for them to dedicate the food basket and that we recognize the family is really important. Thank you, Claudia. Okay. Okay, come on. Okay. Okay, any other joys and concern? Any announcement I forget? No? A little bit update on Deidre. I think she's still in the hospital. She's back in the hospital for complication, and then hopefully gonna discharge soon, and then hopefully Deidre's pray. We are really praying for this trial medication that she's probably gonna ask for the trial medication to start. So please pray for Deidre to be able to get the trial medication, get into the medication program. So, and we, Kathy and Mimi has been still under the weather, still recovering from COVID. And we have some other church family members still struggling and not able to come because of the situation and then because of the illnesses and the treatment and they're getting it. So let's continue to pray for them, right? Amen?
Amen.
We believe in the power of prayer. Amen?
Amen.
Okay. Any other updated announcement or joys and concerns? No? That's good. Let us pray. Eternal God, we come before you this morning with our humble hearts, knowing that you are with us in this place, in this time. God, you called us, you gathered us in this church, and you have been blessing us throughout all these 100 years. God, we thank you for your abundant blessings, your guidance, and your presence. God, we ask you to pray, we really pray for the abundant, continual abundant blessing upon our church, especially those church families who are struggling and dealing with really hard situations. God, you know all the details. We have church families dealing with these terrible illnesses, recovering from surgeries, dealing with also many other difficult issues. God, we ask you to provide your peace and comfort, your solution upon all these struggles. God, we know that you are a mighty healer. So we ask you to provide your mighty healing hands upon them so that they can heal from these illnesses and diseases. God, we have come here to celebrate your abundant blessings last 100 years. God, help us to truly praise you and worship you. Help us to have true hope for the future throughout this worship and days to come. God, we thank you for all the amazing things that you have done in our churches. God, we thank you for, we ask you to provide your continual guidance and blessings upon our church, especially in this darkest time that we're living in. I pray in Jesus' name, in the name of Jesus our Lord, that who taught us pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and glory forever. Amen. Amen. The ushers come forward, please. And we have offertory music, John's family.
You might know our father was a minister in the United Methodist Church for 36 years, so we would like to dedicate this song today to all the pastors that have shepherded Torrance First for 100 years, and all of their families who supported them in their ministry, especially their children.
Join me in the prayer of dedication. Almighty and forgiving God, we, your unworthy servants, give you most humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life. But above all, for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace, and for the hope of glory. Give us such an awareness of your mercies that our hearts may be thankful and that we may show forth your praise not only with our lips, but in our lives by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Christ, Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory forever and ever. Amen.
Okay, children's coming up. As our children's coming up, I'm going to explain to you a little bit. For our centennial celebration and the worship service, the theme of our centennial worship service is gratitude for our heritage and blessings for the future. We recognize our heritage, and also we are asking God's blessing for our future. And our children are the future, right? Yeah, so. How you doing? Okay, stand up. Stand up. Okay. God is good?
All the time.
All the time? Oh, come on. We can do better than this. Okay. We have a guest here. Okay? God is good?
All the time.
All the time?
God is good.
Okay, we are celebrating special Sunday today. What is special? Our? How many years?
100.
Wow, 100. Isn't that amazing? So basically, we are celebrating our birthday. So can we say happy birthday?
Happy birthday.
Okay. Can you say we are church together?
We are church together.
Oh, can you say we are church together? Yes, we are church together, and God formed us in this first United Methodist Church of Torrance as a church. And there are so many amazing church members who faithfully serve our church for many generations. And for future, let me tell you, for future is you. You are our hope. And you are the future of our church. So that's why we really, our parents and all the adults try to support you, help you, pray for you. Okay? Are you gonna do that?
Yeah.
Okay. So we are church together, right? Amen?
Amen?
Okay. So you're gonna sing us, right? Sing praise? Okay. Thank you. Okay. Lynn?
Jesus, Lord of the world, stand upon us, spread us free by That music was thrilling, just beautiful. And it's so good to be here with all of you, dear friends, this morning. The not too auspicious beginning of this church occurred without property and with very little money. The first place of worship was in the Dominguez Land Office, which was used as a land sales office and dining room during the week, and as our congregation's place of worship on Sundays. Incense had to be burned to eliminate the food and the tobacco odors before worship services could be held each Sunday. When First Methodist Episcopal Church of Torrance was incorporated in January 1922, there were about 20 members. Late in 1922, the land office was demolished and the church moved worship services to the American Legion Hall. During this time, land was secured at the present site, and plans were drawn up for the first church building. Ground was broken on April 17, 1923, for this first Methodist church in Torrance. And after considerable volunteer work, the church was dedicated the following September. In 1929, more rooms, including the ladies' parlor and an arcade-style porch, were added to the original sanctuary building, giving the church a Spanish appearance. The indebtedness incurred for this addition lasted until the mortgage was paid off in 1942. The ladies' aid and Sunday school classes helped raise these funds. In 1954, a new three-level educational building was built as the church increased in membership and in ministry. Classrooms in all levels were filled with students. The arcade and ladies' parlor areas developed in 1929 were completely remodeled in 1957 to create office space and a multi-purpose friendship room. Fulfilling early dreams, ground was broken on January 15, 1961, for the erection of a new sanctuary at the corner of El Prado and Manuel Avenues, whose spire rises commanding 75 feet in the air. On October 1st, 1961, the new sanctuary was used for the first time. Shortly after the new sanctuary was built, the original room, no longer needed for worship services, was converted to a social recreation hall. The original kitchen adjacent to the social hall was remodeled in 1964. In 1967, a library was added in the patio area of the church. The basement room, Wesley Hall, was upgraded in 1973. In 1967, the mortgage on the new sanctuary was paid. The mortgage on the El Prado Parsonage was paid in 1971, and in 1992, the mortgage was paid on the 230th Street Parsonage. In 1990, the existing three small offices and the friendship room were remodeled to accommodate three functional offices, a workroom, and a records room. And the friendship room was relocated across the hall. The Social Recreation Hall was completely renovated in 2004, providing a pleasant, versatile room. More recently, in 2010, our present sanctuary was completely refurbished with new lighting and state-of-the-art multimedia equipment, and renovation of the chancel to include relocation of the choir and organ console to that area. The magnificent organ has been rebuilt and was consecrated October 21st, 2018, during an inaugural concert. Several front pews were removed to provide space for flexible chair seating as well as for a variety of uses. A new wall cross, altar, and other furnishings were created from the unneeded pews. In early years, clergy families used the upstairs rooms, the upper rooms, as their parsonage, living room and bedroom only. Their kitchen was the church kitchen, located downstairs, adjacent to the sanctuary. In 1927, a parsonage was built on Manuel Avenue, near the chancel area of our current sanctuary. And in 1953, the house directly across the park at 1542 El Prado was purchased for a larger parsonage. The former parsonage was then used for office space and classrooms. In 1962, a parsonage designed for senior pastor needs was built one block away at 1437 El Prado. The house across the park was then sold. In 1973, a second parsonage was purchased at 2076 West 230th Street for the associate pastor. In almost 20 years, in 2013, the El Prado Parsonage, unused by the clergy and leased by the church for almost 20 years, was sold to provide funds to pay for the organ renovation. Presently, the 230th Street house is used for our parsonage. Growth in church membership occurred simultaneously with the growth of the city. In 1945, church membership stood at 343. 1961, membership was at its peak with 1,536 persons. Changing economic conditions have had a significant impact on our congregation. In December 2022, membership was 271. We are a multi-ethnic congregation and blessed with a large, active Filipino ministry. Over the years, congregations of a variety of cultures have shared our facilities while they established their own churches. We provide meeting space for 12-step groups such as Al-Anon, Nar-Anon, Codependency, and others. In our centennial year 2022, we marked 100 years of mission and ministry, which this church has rendered to the community of Torrance and the world. God has richly blessed us for this work.
Amen.
Amen.
I will be reading the names of the clergy, the men and women who have been appointed to this congregation through all the years. From 1921 to 1923, Gordon Riegler. From 1923 to 1924, James W. Morris. From 1924 to 1926, Fred M. Isig. From 1926 to 1927, Alex Lyle. From 1927 to 1931, Robert A. Young. From 1931 to 1933, Kemp J. Winkler. From 1933 to 1936, Carl Allen. From 1936 to 1938, Bernard C. Brewster. From 1938 to 1940, Harry G. Banks. From 1940 to 1945, Harry Branton. From 1945 to 1949, Clyde E. Rockman. From 1949 to 1952, Clarence E. Miller. From 1952 to 1959, John L. Taylor. From 1959 to 1963, Gilbert S. Zimmerman. From 1963 to 1971, Arthur L. Nagel. From 1971 through 1975, Ray W. Ragsdale. From 1975 to 1984, Truman A. Barrett. From 1984 to 1996, David J. Harada. From 1996 to 1998, Natalie Hotby Haddon. From 1998 through 2006, Joanne Satterberg. From 2006 through 2014, Bob L. Isep. From 2014 through 2022, Stacy C. Dixon. And from 2022 until today, the present, our good-looking Asian pastor, Jacob F. Lee.
So for those of you that don't know, our church had a praise band for about 22 years. We started before the sanctuary was renovated during a power outage. And so last week was particularly poignant for us because it brought back a lot of memories of worshiping in the dark. But it can be done, and here we are today. So normally, Ray would be here to play the drums for us. But doggone it, his lead decided to call for vacation today. How dare she? So I wondered if you might indulge me a little bit and help me by providing the percussion. So I'm going to ask you to snap if you do this. Come on, you can do it. There you go.
Keep going.
Amen. I don't know about you, but the statement that Reverend Joanne Sederberg read is the evidence of God's abundant blessing upon our church. And I think Claudia put it really nicely in the flower offering. The statement in there is for the thanks for the visionary people and their stewardship for our church, which have served so many people for 100 years. And with encouragement of those now surrounding us in a great cloud of witness, we take our place in the long line of the people of God who are blessed to call First United Methodist Church of Torrance history, which is our history. So this time, I would like to recognize some of our faithful church members. And we're going to actually detailly recognize while we do the program after the lunch, but I want to recognize them as a standing up, and then we give a big applause to those who church members who faithfully serve our church. Would you please, the family members who's, you know, who your loved ones who serve our church as a pastor or church members, and then your loved ones went to heaven. Would you please stand, church members? Carrie, yeah. All church members, stand up, please. Yeah. All right, thank you, thank you. I thought we had more people. No? Okay. Okay. Now, let's recognize our church members who have been here over 50 years. Claudia said that, yeah. Thank you. By the way, today is Carol's birthday. Yeah. Hey, Carol, happy birthday. Yeah. Okay. I was going to remain standing, but that's okay. Those of you who come to church about 30 years, more than 30 years, would you please stand? 30 years. Yeah. Okay, remain standing, please. We're going to do this in, as I planned it. Remain standing. Okay, those who come to church more than 10 years, will you please stand? Come on. Yeah. And now, everybody stand up. Because I'm telling you, it is God's guidance that who gather us here in this church. Whether you come just for today, or 10 years, 50 years, it's God who gathers us here. So that's the blessings and that's the grace that we're celebrating today. Amen? So let's read together recognition of our longtime Thanksgiving. Eternal and loving God, we give thanks to you for your goodness through all the years of worship and witness in this place. For your grace in calling us to be your people, for your love revealed to us in Christ your Son, for your gift of the Spirit and the joy of salvation. For those who established this congregation, for their faith and vision, for their gifts and abilities. For all who have been members of this congregation, for those who have given freely of their times and money, for those whose wisdom guided our congregation. For all who have preached and taught here, for all who have confessed here that Jesus is Lord, for all who have today led in worship, witness, and service. Let's read together. Give us the assurance that we too belong to that great company and that we too may find the peace that is understanding through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Please be seated. Thank you.
Our scripture reading for today is from John chapter 17, verses 1 through 11. After Jesus had spoken these words, he looked up to the heaven and said, "Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, so that the Son may glorify you, since you have given him authority over all people to give eternal life to all whom you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth by finishing the work that you gave me to do. So now, Father, glorify me in your own presence with the glory that I had in your presence before the world existed. I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything you have given me is from you. For the words that you gave to me, I have given to them, and they have received them, and know in truth that I came from you. And they have believed that you sent me. I am asking on their behalf. I am not asking on behalf of those of the world, but on behalf of those whom you gave me, because they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. It is really a joy for me to be here this morning with all of you as you celebrate your centennial, or I guess this is the culmination of the past year's celebration of 100 years. It's also really good to see and hear Hani Young on the organ and the piano. When I started as your district superintendent 7 years ago, Hani at that time was the accompanist, the organist over at Lakewood First United Methodist Church. And so now that I am concluding my superintendency, she's moved west, and it's great to hear her play this morning. I have been fortunate to worship here in this sanctuary at least several times, at least pre-pandemic, several times. But just today I noticed, and you may be the only church, at least on the west, for this, but just today I noticed that you do not have a clock on the back wall. You know, most sanctuaries, they position that clock on the back wall, right in the line of sight of the preacher. You know, but I just noticed you don't have that. However, I do notice where the sermon is placed in today's worship, right towards the end of our time, right before the benediction and the sending forth. So I get the hint, okay? And plus, you're getting hungry. That lunch is starting to get into your stomach, so I get it, okay? In addition to celebrating your 100th anniversary, today is also the day of Ascension on the Christian calendar. The Ascension connects with the resurrection. Christ died and rose so that we will have eternal life. And he ascended so that we might be given a share in his divinity, his continuing presence, and therefore his life with God. As the season of Easter draws to a close and next Sunday you will celebrate Pentecost, we see the early church slowly transforming, taking the experience of encountering the risen Christ and trying to find ways to make it real in their world. The Spirit, Jesus prays, will help the disciples to understand more and more of all that Jesus has shown and taught them. Today's scripture reading from John 17 is commonly known as Jesus's farewell discourse, his final message to his disciples before he is to meet his fate in Jerusalem. This passage also is sometimes called Jesus's high priestly prayer. Like the high priest who prayed on behalf of Israel, Jesus prays for others on the eve of his death. In John's gospel, Jesus dies when the Passover lamb is slain in the temple. The other gospels place Jesus' death the next day. Jesus offers this prayer immediately before entering the Garden of Gethsemane. Unlike the other gospel accounts, where Jesus prays in the garden and where his prayer struggles with his impending death, here in John's gospel, Jesus is affirming the hour that has come as his glorification. And the prayer's power lies in Jesus' request that God will protect the disciples, the church, and keep the church unified. Jesus prays for those who are called to embody God's love in his presence. If God's love is seen, it will be through their and our witness. Now, this emphasis on unity doesn't mean that all Christians are expected to agree, but rather it offers hope that we will recognize that what unites us is far greater than what divides us. Glory in John has to do with revealing who God is. It is how God becomes known to human beings. It is something that the disciples have already seen and heard in the signs that Jesus performed earlier in this gospel. They tasted God's spirit and love at the wedding of Cana back in chapter 2 of this gospel. They smelled it in Bethany when Lazarus was called back to life in the 11th chapter. Jesus wants even more glory for his disciples. This prayer ends with the hope that they will see the fullness of glory in God's love. It is not mere togetherness that Jesus prays for his family, but the hope that they and we will find intimacy with God through being part of God's family, the church. Now, I don't know if today's centennial celebration was intentionally planned to coincide with the Ascension, but it's a good fit, particularly given today's gospel reading. The unity expressed in today's reading from John is certainly part of the DNA of this church and has been for the past 100 years. No church or any organization survives 100 years unless it has a high degree of unity. Certainly, there have been disagreements along the way, and no doubt, a few feathers have been ruffled in some church council meetings over the years. But to celebrate 100 years in ministry together says much about Torrance First. Through all of the ministries that are outlined there in the brief history in the program, through all of those ministries, this church has exemplified God's love and care for all of God's people. Through the ways that this church has met so many challenges over the decades, particularly the financial ones, as all churches have, you and your forebears have lived on faith rather than in fear. Through the diversity expressed, not just this morning, but again on my previous worships here in this sanctuary, you have opened your arms through God's open spirit and have welcomed everybody into the life of your church family. This is your glory, and this is God's presence here in this church glorified. Glorified by who you are, what you do, and the joyful ways in which you worship. As many churches seek to grow in their understanding of Christian unity, and beyond that to the interconnectedness of so many communities nowadays, we remember Jesus's simple plea that we all be one. Not one in every decision that needs to be made, not to be one in the ways we necessarily think, but to be one in the spirit of Jesus Christ, a spirit that calls us to reach out with the love of God through the communion of the Holy Spirit and to be a community that welcomes and embraces everybody. Particularly in a world that is becoming, on the one hand, so fractured, but yet on the other hand, interconnected with a wide diversity of religious beliefs. God calls us to be one in spirit and to move forward as the family, united and connected to God through Jesus Christ. This has been the glory of Torrance First for your first 100 years. And as you now enter your second 100 years, I pray that you will continue to embrace the spirit that is found in this week's gospel reading from John 17, to hear the call of Jesus, to respond to that call through unity in the Holy Spirit. This will be your glory in the next 100 years to come. An ancient Chinese proverb says, the journey of 1,000 miles begins with the first step. Let this be your first step on towards your next century of ministry, so that 100 years from today, those of you who are still here by chance, will be able to celebrate and continue the great legacy of Torrance First United Methodist Church. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Would you please stand?
take your next steps to your next 100 years of ministry. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the communion of the Holy Spirit, the love of God be with you all, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.